his attitude as much as his game. Wilson, a very dedicated pro. But O'Sullivan played quite superbly against Shanghander earlier on, and produces that sort of form. He's got to be favourite to progress through to tomorrow's quarterfinals.
First frame.
Once again, it's best
Ronnie O'Sullivan to break.
So the left-handed break again from Ronnie O'Sullivan. I always find it strange why he always breaks off left-handed. But he plays so well with it that, well, why not? Big moment sees Kyron Wilson. As David said, never played each other before. And the cue ball just crept in behind the green. Otherwise, that red would have been on to the corner. I like that cue ball tight into the bunch of reds there.
As Kyron Wilson said, he's trying to get going again. He was runner-up in the Indian Open in July. Didn't enter the International Championship and didn't fare too well in the English Open. He's just looking for matches, really, and results.
Doesn't want that cue ball in the pocket.
O'Sullivan is known for his centuries and his maximums. He made a break in the third frame against Shanghander. That had to be seen to be believed. He was only 35. I say only, but the balls, well, they weren't so much safe when he came to the table as locked away. It was just an unbelievable break to win the frame. Class of 92 in the arena this evening. O'Sullivan and John Higgins is playing Mark Williams. That's on the Eurosport player on table two. Kyron Wilson was born in December 91, so he's very much the new generation.
Yeah, it's not straightforward to get that cue ball back to the block area.
What?
So, he didn't hold his hand up, so did he play that plant? We know he played the cue ball where it is. Incredible shot. And that cue ball just kept running and running. I think he's on the red. Is he?
Four.
No, he's not on the red to the right corner. So two really excellent shots from O'Sullivan, and it's just 4 points.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, four.
Bit of good safety.
Whoever wins this match will play the winner of the match on table two between Higgins and Williams. O'Sullivan and Higgins, the two men in form really, particularly of course John Higgins having won the last two tournaments. I think Karen Wilson will be overall. There's no reason for him to be. When he won the Shanghai Masters, he beat Ding Junhui, Mark Allen and Judd Trump. And of course, he got to the quarterfinals at the Crucible end of last season, was loving it in Sheffield. Beat Joe Perry and Mark Allen there. And he said, I think I'll win this one day. And that wasn't arrogance. It was confidence. And there is a difference. He's saying it having already won a tournament. It's not like some rookie going there talking himself up. It's important to believe in yourself, because if you don't, this game's very difficult.
Yes, it means just as much as ability, the belief that you can win. Most of the top players have got it.
Stephen Hendry, when he was a teenager, said he thought he would win the world championship by the age of 21. Well, he did, and he's still the youngest ever world champion.
Well, the safety play so far in this game has been excellent. Wilson's been on the back foot, just playing the containing safety shot each time, but he's managed not to leave anything. Well, that was the red that was causing a little bit of a problem on the safety. Now with that red removed, maybe can start playing the conventional safety shots.
I think this could be a really good night's snooker. It's great to see another large crowd in, of course. After this match, they'll be watching Mark Allen, although we don't yet know who Allen's going to be playing, because Sam Baird and Gary Wilson are in a decider. But great to see this tournament being so well supported here in Belfast.
Well, maybe a half chance to the right corner, but only if you can escape with that cue ball. Not easy, this. Cue ball looks to be going into the red. That's just behind the black spot. So played the safety again. And not often that you see and Sullivan playing this much safety, but he hasn't had anything to go at. Karen Wilson has played some good safety. He refused that long red just now, O'Sullivan. So Wilson with a chance. Yeah, good pot.
Well.
Choice of black or blue. Oh, that's a mistake.
Karen Wilson what?
Maybe he was just thinking about the cannon on the yellow too much to hold for the red. Can't afford to miss them.
One.
So immediately playing for the blue, get the blue back on its spot. That frees the black to go into that middle pocket. Oh, he hasn't played that well. That's not a good shot from Ronnie O'Sullivan. But that is... But wasn't a kind kiss on the green. So maybe just try and lay in behind it. Like that.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, seven.
Well, this is what he's had, and it's a secret weapon for O'Sullivan, discipline. He's had it all season. If something goes slightly wrong, get your opponent in trouble. He's very patient right now, and that really dispelled trouble for the rest.
He's misjudged this one.
Foul and the miss. Ronnie O'Sullivan, four. Yeah.
Very nearly left the red to the right corner. But back it goes.
Rob Spencer, the man in charge, out in the middle.
Karen. Ronnie.
Well, that's better. If it was harder.
Foul and a miss.
He's found the line.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, four. Karen, a bit closer. Yeah, Ronnie.
Well, this looks hard enough, but has he got the line? I don't think he has. He's left the red on, and that's a disaster, really. He'd rather have left it short again, given them 4 points away.
8.
Yes, he can just get through to the red.
9.
Hasn't got used to the table speed yet, though. He's left that one short. Left the last one short. 10. This needs to bounce big.
14. Ronnie O'Sullivan, no. 14.
That was a missed opportunity. And Karen Wilson has to try and make as many points as he can, because these opportunities won't come by so often.
One.
Nice angle on the black to either go into the reds or play that plant that he just looked at. 10. Played that very well, and that's exactly what he played. The cannon to the red has 8. Left him on choice of reds.
Well, I mentioned O'Sullivan has been disciplined, but that certainly applies to Karen Wilson as well. He's a good pro, works with Barry Stark, his coach, and very dedicated.
9.
And that's opened the rest of the reds.
Well, he's certainly a heavy scorer when he gets going. Last season, he played a match, China Open qualifying with Anthony Hamilton. Best of 9. There were 6 centuries in a row in the match. He had 4, Hamilton had 2. Incredible. That was a qualifying match. If he's going to win the match, I would suggest he's got to win frames like this where O'Sullivan has missed and let him in.
10. Yes, he caught the pink instead of the red. He needed to catch the inside of the 20. Pink on the other side. Caught the pink fuller and not on anything. Had he caught the right hand side of the pink, he'd have pushed the red towards that right corner. So a let off for Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Karen Wilson, 20.
Yes, it was a good chance that for Wilson, but he goes back to his seat, in fact trailing. 10. Tip is clearly on his mind. He said he felt it sounded a little odd in his first match, although to the untrained eye it didn't seem much wrong against Zangander.
10. Well, not sure if he went for the pot there. But if he did, it was dangerous. Collided with the other red and could have gone anywhere. This red is possible to the left corner. It's a proper thin one, this.
I can tell you that Gary Wilson has beaten Sam Baird 4-3, so Gary Wilson, no relation to Kyron, is going to play Mark Allen on this table after this match.
Safety play by both players. Excellent. And Ronnie O'Sullivan showing lots of patience. But looks like Kyron Wilson's having a go at this red. And my word, what a tough one. What a great pop that was from Kyron Wilson. He was leaving reds on and he missed that one. What a confident pot. And that will make any opponent think when he sees his opponent taking on shots like that and getting them. Got to go back to that red again. What a positive shot that was, especially after that sustained bout of safety. He's up for this match, Kyron Wilson.
Eight.
He's under hit it. He's the wrong side of the pink. Wanted to be fairly straight on the pink so he could get back to the reds. It's going to have to be the blue. Not this time.
Kyron Wilson, eight.
Well, it's disappointing because that's the second chance he's had in the frame and he's still trailing.
Well, again, that was a very confident blue to take on. But they have to go in.
Well.
He's got choice of black or pink, but the pink looks the better ball because he wouldn't have to do too much with the cue ball.
Seven. Eight.
Under hit it. If he takes the black, he's got to miss the brown. Just missed it. But where's it going to finish? I don't think it's good.
15. Ryan O'Sullivan, 15.
points the difference. Hasn't refused anything yet, Kyron Wilson.
Eight.
Another terrific shot. And couldn't have played it any better. Stun run through, finishing perfect on the black.
Well, that really tells us the frame of mind that Karen Wilson is in. He's taking the game to Ronnie O'Sullivan this evening. And I'll tell you what, he's the sort of character who'll be excited to play him. He won't be afraid of him. You do see some players overawed against the great champions, but Karen Wilson, he's not of that mindset.
This is a big shot, though. It's slightly off the cushion.
Nine.
Well, I wasn't sure. And now you would think the green is the only thing that could save O'Sullivan in this frame.
Eighteen.
Well, that's gone as bad as it could, really. It's one of those awful little cutbacks. Another inch and it would have been practically a gimme. Nicely played.
21.
And that was the way to play it.
So he needs brown to pink to seal the opening frame. It's a good sign for Karen Wilson supporters if he's going for his shots, and it's a better sign if they're going in, which that red did from distance to initiate this break.
30.
And it's not been straightforward, the rest of it, but it just needs the pink and he's won the opening frame. O'Sullivan stands to see him pot it. This could be a really interesting evening of snooker, I think. Karen Wilson is not afraid of the top stars. And he's won the opening frame. He leads Ronnie O'Sullivan 1-0. O'Sullivan still a little concerned with his tip. We think he just left the arena there to do something to it.
Well, that safety shot turned out not to be one. Caught it much too thin. And this is a half chance for Wilson.
Well, in the first frame, he potted 4 out of the 5 long balls he attempted. And there's another one. Bang in the middle of the pocket, that was.
Never played each other before, and sometimes when you haven't played a person and you've never seen them play, then it's always awkward. And Ronnie O'Sullivan not used to this guy's game. Of course, Karen Wilson will have seen Ronnie O'Sullivan play many, many times. Karen Wilson knows what to expect. But O'Sullivan, when he sees those long balls going in, and somebody that's not afraid of him, May take a while for him just to realise that this is well and truly a match that he's in.
Six.
Karen Wilson has an important couple of weeks, just looking to shore up his top 16 position. The cut-off for the Masters is after the UK Championship, which is the next tournament.
13.
That would be his debut in the Games Leading Invitation event, and then cement his place, of course, for later in the season so that he doesn't have to qualify for the Crucible.
14.
But, of course, he doesn't just want to be a top 16 player, this young man. He wants to be world number one.
Thank you. 20.
Oh, what about that for a cheeky shot? And played it hard enough to get that cue ball out for the pink. What about that? Now, where does the pink go? Where does the pink go? If it doesn't go on its spot, this could come to spoil things, and that is so unfortunate. Oh, that's a terrible stroke of luck, that. So, just a safety.
27.
Could have won the frame at that visit. Sullivan still looking at his tip.
Yeah, and you don't want distractions, particularly, of course, if it's to do with the equipment you're using. And he's already seen he's playing someone very hungry. Karen Wilson played a great shot to keep the break going, but goes back to his seat after making 27.
Well, he had to catch it thin to avoid the double kiss. But he's struggling at the moment. That's maybe just what he needed, a let-off. Although I think at first glance that Karen's got away with this. Just got that little bit of run in there when he needed it, Karen Wilson. Good safety. That's an excellent safety shot. Played it with a lot of right-hand side on the cue ball to try and check the cue ball back down in behind the green. The white seemed to die as it hit that cushion, and that's with all the side on it. So this safety shot a lot easier than it should have been. Again, good safety from O'Sullivan. Don't think he can see enough of the red over the right side of the table to pot it. Ah, he can. And he may be forced into taking this one on. Hasn't missed much. And he hasn't missed that one either.
One.
And Sullivan must wonder what he has to do.
It's interesting though, isn't it? When you take away choice, you take away doubt. He had to go for that, and it really focused the mind. But it has to be said, his long potting's been excellent tonight. He's potted 6 out of 7 now.
Well, what a great chance to take a 2-0 lead.
Three. Four.
He plays a slightly different game, but he reminds me in terms of his attitude to Judd Trump when he broke through as a big tournament winner, China Open and UK Championship winner in 2011, and of course between that was world finalist, really taking them on and being worried about reputations of his opponents. And like Trump, Wilson served his apprenticeship through the qualifiers.
Nine.
Learned his trade, he's taken the knocks, but he's clearly revelling being now a top 16 player.
Ten.
The important thing is that he feels comfortable in these big arenas. Having won that title in Shanghai, runner-up in India, loves it out there. Much rather be here on table one than stuck out the back.
Sixteen.
All already a useful lead with all, with the four reds on the cushion.
Thanks, Gary. Thank you. 17.
Just doesn't look like missing.
23. 24.
Well, that's the first positional shot where he's not absolutely on the ball that he wanted to be on. Wanted to be straighter on the pink. Still needs a couple of reds. Wait for it. Wait for it.
Foul. Karen Wilson, 30. Ronnie O'Sullivan,
you've got
four.
To say that that is a mistake. Cue ball shouldn't have been anywhere near the middle pocket. ~53 the difference. 67 on. And not the best safety. He was trying to bring reds into play, but he was taking a risk on where they were going to go. One of them's gone close to the pocket. There's another long pot.
Well, he's just doing the maths. He needs one more red, the one that's out in the open.
Well, he certainly got hold of that one. And nearly went in off again. There was a lot of adrenaline in that shot.
Three.
And I don't think he can get to the potting angle of the red.
Karen Wilson, three.
So not safe yet.
No, he leads by 56. 59 available. All the reds on the cushion.
And nothing going right for O'Sullivan at the moment. That safety shot. Got the double kiss on. Oh, what another great pot from Kyron Wilson. And O'Sullivan must wonder what he has to do.
Well, what he has to do in this frame is get a couple of snookers. This is what you call taking the game to Ronnie O'Sullivan. Look at this again, a fantastic long red from Wilson. Again, bang in the middle of that pocket.
And what's that, David? 7 out of 8?
It's 8 out of 9, in fact.
Yeah, that's some going. And they've been good shots, these long reds that he's potted.
Well, it's an encouraging sign that O'Sullivan didn't concede there. He was snookered. He needs two snookers, but he's playing on. He's still concerned about the tip, but I think more concerned about the way his opponent is playing.
Yeah, his opponent is playing superbly, and that's got nothing to do with his tip.
One.
Well, that makes sure of this game. Didn't hold his hand up, so we'll assume he played that.
Well, he's had a quiet spell of late on the circuit, Wilson, but my word, things are really warming up from here.
Six.
And the next frame is a big one. If he can get to 3-0, he'll really, really fancy the job. He clearly already does, which is half the battle against Ronnie O'Sullivan in form. Kyron Wilson knocking in some great pots. And he's got himself already halfway to victory here in Belfast this evening. He leads Ronnie O'Sullivan by 2-0. But because of how well Wilson has played for that lead, particularly his long potting has been excellent. Self-belief, such an important part of the game, not an easy commodity to summon up, but Wilson has it, and we've seen that from some of the pots he's knocked in during the course of the match. That was in the first frame, just going in the middle of the pockets as well. So impressive, Joe.
Yes, but not just his long pots, his safety's been excellent as well. He's kept O'Sullivan off the table.
Well, long pot stats. In fairness to O'Sullivan, he's only taken one on. He didn't pot it. There's the overall pot success. But again, Wilson has taken far more on.
Well, there's another long pot here to the right corner. Just looking to see if the black will go to that left corner pocket.
Safety also favouring Wilson. Everything's favouring Wilson at the moment.
There's what? Another. A cracking shot. Well, he must feel like he can't miss, and O'Sullivan must think that he can't leave him anything at all.
Yeah, that's why I mentioned Judd Trump 2011, because this is sort of snooker. They called it naughty snooker, but it's really just high quality attacking, getting in with these cracking long pots.
Thank you. Four.
Well, he's under hit that one. So the next red from the blue, not straightforward. Well, he tried to make something happen.
Nine.
Screwing the blue in, coming around the two cushions. And he might just be on this red to the left corner. Yep, it goes.
So.
Well, if the blue passes the pink, he can go into that cluster. And that's what he's looking at now. And if he can hit the right side of the cluster, it should open nicely. straight in the gap of those two reds. Well, that's worked out. He's okay, he's on one.
15.
Well, that was the first poor positional shot.
22.
Pink will go to the right middle. And he may have to play for it to that right middle pocket.
23.
This is a guy that made four centuries.
29.
In a match that David adhered to earlier. Prolific break builder.
30.
And then again, that was an excellent shot he's played. With the rest, left-hand side on the cue ball to avoid the reds. And finishing up perfectly on the blue.
35.
One important thing is not to 36. Get ahead of himself, not to get overexcited, just concentrate on every shot. Because that man is a big scalp, but you can't afford to think about that at this stage.
42.
And just about the right side of the pink to stun for these two reds.
43.
What a performance this is from Kyron Wilson so far.
49. 50.
So the last of the easy reds. And he's going to need another one.
57.
Now, does this red behind the black, does it go to the right corner? The one closest to the cushion does, and he'd only need that red. 's like the one behind the black will go. And he couldn't have took these any better.
63.
No, it's been flawless stuff. from Karen Wilson in this frame, and this red to secure the frame. And he's missed it.
Wow.
Karen Wilson.
How important will that
63.
Be?
63.
Wow. Now, can he get to the red? That's on the cushion. Why would he want to split the red and black? Why not just make sure of the red?
Well, if ever there was a potential turning point, this is it.
One.
Well, dead right, David, because if he wins this frame, O'Sullivan, he's right back in this match, and Wilson will be thinking. But he has to win it. Just to make that guy there think, why did I try and split the red and black? Why not just pop the red? Stun out for the pink.
Nine.
Yeah, the 20 or so good shots he played up to that point may have been for nothing, may count for nothing here. It's out of his hands. And it's in the hands of the best player ever to pick up a cue.
Still not an easy clearance.
16.
Two reds close to the cushion.
17.
Just checking the scoreboard. And that is just about perfect on the red. 39 points behind, so
24.
Any colours, really. Oh, well.
Ronnie O'Sullivan. 24.
Even O'Sullivan suffers with nerves sometimes. What a let off.
What? Thank you.
I think O'Sullivan will feel even worse than if Wilson had just won the frame at one visit, because he had his chance. He was poised to make a clearance, one of many that he's made that have turned matches, but this is going to be 3-0. Wilson can forget about his own little wobble.
Eight. Karen Wilson, eight on the frame.
Sullivan remains in his seat. He had his chance there to possibly turn the tide in this match. He was being outplayed, but Wilson, a man reprieved, delighted to see that red in the jaws. He's leading O'Sullivan by 3-0. He was reprieved when O'Sullivan himself missed.
Yes, and an excellent break. Cue ball dead under the cushion. Great pot. What a terrific pot. Just to let Karen Wilson know that he can get them too. It was a great break off. It was a great red.
Nine. Seventeen. Twenty-four. Thank you. 25.
Didn't have the angle to come back down for the black. But played onto the blue very nicely. And that's worked out beautifully.
Beautiful. Thirty-nine.
Well, he knows that he needs to produce something here. This is a great chance to win this frame very swiftly. Just remind Karen Wilson the match is not yet over.
Yes, he'll stay focused.
47.
But if O'Sullivan can win the frame at one visit, just may make him think a little that he can't afford to let up in any way, shape or form.
Fifty-four. Fifty-five. Sixty-two. 63.
Still needs another red after this black.
70. Well, he's being forced into playing his best stuff. He needs this really for the remainder of the match.
71.
Yeah, you can't keep knocking great balls in. That was a terrific red that he knocked in right at the beginning of this break. But if that's what he's got to do each time, it's a big ask.
Here this it is.
78.
And that's the red.
79.
This frame has been going just 5 minutes.
Eighty-four. 85.
Obviously can't make the highest break, which is 147, John Higgins, but this will make him feel a lot better.
92. 93.
My word, he needed this century to get himself going after having been outplayed for most of the evening.
101.
And it's been made in the blink of an eye.
108.
The break ends at 108. That frame took 6 minutes. Ronnie O'Sullivan extends the match. Karen Wilson not home yet.
Well, hasn't played a shot for 6 or 7 minutes, Karen Wilson. All he did in the last frame was break off. And it was a good break off.
Thank you. Wolf.
Well, when you consider the balls he's knocked in, that was a real bad sign that he's missed that.
Well. Six. Seven. Fourteen.
Well, what a good pot on the red to the left, that left corner there.
15.
And he's off again. But this is down to a miss by Kyron Wilson.
22.
We can see it again, this pink.
23.
Well, O'Sullivan's just made 108. And the balls are lined nice again. And as well as Wilson has played, he hasn't won yet.
29. 30.
And this is where O'Sullivan has to keep his discipline. Can't afford to lose concentration and miss an easy one. So easy to do.
30.
Like the way he played that shot. Gave himself choice of three reds.
37.38. 43.
Let's be honest, it would be just like Ronnie O'Sullivan from 3-0 down to win the match with four centuries. He's not there yet, but he's certainly sprung to life just when he had to. It's already up to 50 here.
Fifty-one. 58. 59.
Well, the pink goes easy enough. It's the red that he's concerned about.
65. Had that
66.
Chance to win the third frame, had the chance to make the clearance, didn't make it. Wilson was in a very strong position at 3-0. He's still in a strong position now, but 3-2 with a couple of big breaks. Pressure's on him now if he gets a chance in the next frame, because in this one he missed that simple pink.
Beautiful shot, bringing the red off the cushion, staying on the other red. This is the pink that Kyron missed. Maybe thinking about where he wanted to be on the next red.
Well, Ronnie O'Sullivan has his new novel out today. It's been published today. It's called Framed. And this match is turning into a real page-turner, isn't it? Fantastic viewing. And Ronnie O'Sullivan supporters delighted to see him pull another one back in style, punishing that miss from Kyron Wilson. So it looks like back-to-back tons.
Like that one.
Well, unless you're sat in the non-striker's chair, how can you not, really? I mean, this is just fantastic snooker. From 3-0 down, struggling to this man playing well, O'Sullivan with back-to-back centuries.
117.
And Kyron Wilson knows he can't afford to miss. He can't afford to make unforced errors, because O'Sullivan in the mood to punish. 108. Followed by 117. Ronnie O'Sullivan has made this a whole lot closer. He was bang in trouble, trailing 3-0. But now there is only one in it.
And the last time he broke off, he left it dead on the cushion. O'Sullivan won the frame, made a century. Another good break off. This is an extremely thin cut. If he takes it on to that left middle, then he won't know where the cue ball's going to go.
Yeah, we're seeing stats there that show O'Sullivan has scored more points, potted more balls. Of course, that's because of the two centuries. And I tell you what, when he was making them, he wasn't hanging around. Average shot time, 16 seconds. That's for the whole match, but for the two breaks, lower than that. And they're the highest breaks, of course. He just had a 117. Wilson, 63, his best. They are the average shot times. 10 seconds between them.
Lots of left-hand side on the cue ball to try and drag it in behind the yellow dead on the cushion. Pretty good shot. Caught it a touch thick. And he might just have left a little tempter to this right corner. But got to be careful because that red next to the pink, to the left of the pink, would be available to the left corner if you should miss it. Could screw the cue ball back for the brown and green, just in case. Well, he got a big kick, but the red went in. Great shot.
Yeah, the cue ball jumped in the air, but the red ran true to the pocket.
And he's off again. And now it's O'Sullivan that's getting the long pots. Decided to go into them.
Three.
Well, this is awkward. The red to the left middle. Cue ball looks to be going into the blue. Good
four.
Pot, and played it with a touch of stunt to get the right side of the blue. Now, will he decide to open them again or play for that red just to the right of the black? Played for the red to the right of the black. And he could play the cannon to those two reds to try and hold for the black. Or he could play up for the blue.
So.
He's concerned if it's too hard.
15. Sixteen.
And now back in prime position. He could play the cannon to those two reds just above the black. But if they go, there's no need to play it.
And you can just see how much it really does mean to Ronnie O'Sullivan. All this stuff about coming here to get match practice. He's here to win, because he is a winner. One of the great champions of the sport.
Yeah, and great fighters as well.
Back to the wall at 3-0 down, but my word, as you say, Joe, come out fighting, and well, he's in again with a chance for 3-3.
31.
Yeah, I remember you saying something, I think it was in the second
32.
Frame, where he needed two snookers, he'd been totally outplayed, and yet he still came back to the table. Didn't have any chance of getting the snookers, but the intent was there to play on.
The thing about that was he was snookered as he came to the table. 59. And sometimes you do see players concede, but no, he gave it his best.
40.
Now, all the reds seem to be covering one another. Just one more loose red. Well, depends what kind of an angle
47.
He's got. He's okay.
48.
But it's not out of the woods yet. May have to play a cannon to the red above the black. Has it worked out? Can he see this red to the middle?
55.
Can see the red to the corner.
56.
Well, he deserved to be on a red from splitting the pack off the black.
Well, it looks like we're going all the way, doesn't it? And since going 3-0 up, Karen Wilson has potted one ball.
Yes, and it was the pink 58. That he missed after that one ball that started it.
59.
So, this red, and it's 3-3. What a recovery 66. This has been. Just brilliant.
67.
Wonderful snooker. And what did you say, David? I wouldn't be surprised if he made four centuries. Well, every chance of making three now.
74.
There's no one quite like him, is there?
75.
About a year ago, he was finally recognised in the New Year's Honours list for his services to sport. He's never once been on the shortlist for BBC Sports Personality of the Year, despite his achievements and despite having a personality.
82.
Incredible, really.
83.
I know one thing, every sport would like to have a Ronnie O'Sullivan.
90. 91.
Well, everybody that's here tonight will remember this night.
98. 99.
So this black then, for three centuries in three frames.
Brilliant. Such a shame there's got to be a loser in this match, because Kyron Wilson played equally well in the first three.
111.
Not with century breaks, but he knocked in some great balls.
115.
Well, talk about a game of two halves. He's gone from being like a man dying of thirst, crawling through the desert, to suddenly discovering an ocean.
...126.
This is as good as it gets, I promise you. So 126 to follow the two centuries in the preceding two frames, and in no time at all, from the brink of defeat, Ronnie O'Sullivan has forced a decider. Don't go away. It's 3-3, the decider is next.
Important to get a good break off. And that's good.
Karen Wilson has potted one ball in the last three frames. That was in frame five. It's not actually that long since he potted a ball. That's not that long. It's just that O'Sullivan played so quickly. But it was frame five. Then, of course, he missed that pink to let O'Sullivan in.
Yeah, good safety. Karen nodding his head. It's hard to put that cue ball anywhere. Wherever he puts it, he feels that O'Sullivan is going to knock something in. Well, that's pretty good. Well, the double kiss could have been worse. There is a red available to the right corner. Not sure if he can get to a colour from it. And it's a tough pot as well, so unless he can just drop it in and be on the black, it's risky. Good pot. Good. Wanted that black to bounce a little. Well, what a big shot this is. What a big shot this is. But he could play it in such a way as to block the pocket if he misses it. If it goes in, it'd be on the red. Nicely played. So it's Wilson that gets the first chance.
Well, right from the start of the evening,
eight.
Karen Wilson has gone for his shots. And it's not like it's been a load of mistakes. This man has been flawless. It's just that, I guess that one miss really on the pink was the glaring error.
Well, he had no idea what was happening to the cue ball. Just trusted to luck a little. Nothing else he could do, really. The red was so thin. So, end of break.
Could be clear for me, please, Karen. Blue ball.
My word.
Foul. Karen Wilson 10, Ronnie O'Sullivan 5.
It's a misjudgment, that.
Yes, it misjudged it by a long way, really. He was playing to hit the left side cushion and dropping behind the yellow. Choice of reds to play. Well, you could say that that's a let off.
Well, just while we watch that again, I can tell you that the great run of John Higgins has come to an end. He's won the last two events, but he won't be winning this one because on table two, Mark Williams has just beaten him 4-1. A terrific win for Williams. So it won't be O'Sullivan, Higgins in the quarters. It might be neither of them. Higgins has departed. Ronnie O'Sullivan, of course, still has to get this frame. And my word, he wants it. So a mistake from O'Sullivan.
How costly is it going to be? Difficult shots these in deciders.
One.
It's another great pot, though. And he's nicely on the blue. All down to Karen Wilson. Nothing he can do about it now. Just going to sit and hope he gets back to the table.
We could argue it's a
six.
Better win to win 4-3 than 4-0, because 4-0 you could say, well, O'Sullivan didn't produce anything. Well, my word, he certainly produced it last three frames.
Seven. Twelve. 13. Nineteen. 20.
Just about get to the red, to that left corner. Anxious moments. Well, that didn't go according to plan. And if he should take the pink onto the middle, it's well and truly missable. Just 32 points the difference. Slightly hampered if he takes the yellow on. Could push a colour safe. But this is a chance to win. It's there. What a brave shot to take on, and it could be the winner.
Well, it was a pink in frame five that helped turn the match in O'Sullivan's favour. That was a pink that Wilson missed. He didn't miss this one, though. And he's got himself into a very strong position. He leads by 38.
Yeah, what a brave shot that was on the pink. It was so tough.
34.
Well, I think it's encouraging to see that he hasn't compromised the approach that he had right from the start tonight when he took the game to O'Sullivan. That has been his mindset in the decider as well, despite the way Ronnie O'Sullivan has played to get back to 3-3.
40.
3 centuries from O'Sullivan in a best of seven, and he could yet lose.
Well, 51 points the difference. He still needs a couple of reds. And this one isn't a gimme. One more red needed after the pink or black.
Sullivan can only tie as it stands.
54.
Well, he doesn't have to take this red on. He could play the red next to the black and push the black to the cushion. But if it goes in...
55, that's gone.
What a feeling he must be feeling.
Well, every credit to Kyron Wilson. I mean, to beat Ronnie O'Sullivan for a start is an achievement, but after O'Sullivan made 3 centuries on the spin to force the decider, I mean, a lot of players would have buckled, but Kyron Wilson has been fearless, as evidenced by match ball red. Proof once again that this man is a big occasion player.
Thank you. 62.
And if he carries on like this, Ronnie O'Sullivan knows we could be looking at the winner. John Higgins is out. He's knocked out Ronnie O'Sullivan. But seriously impressive, Joe. Great match as well.
69.
One of the best matches I've seen, I got to say, for lots of different reasons.
Cheers.
He's 70. Really gone up in my estimation, Kyron Wilson. I knew he was a good player before, but for what he's done tonight, brilliant.
Yes, it's been a fantastic match. Kyron Wilson played world-class snooker to lead 3-0. Ronnie O'Sullivan threw everything at him. 3 centuries on the spin.